The following program is brought to you by Greater Exodus Baptist Church. Now here is today's message.
And so you don't have a reason to be walking around being a hypocrite, because God knows. The Bible says that these despicable human beings, they all walked away. But bottom line, the reason why they walked away, bottom line, was because what Jesus did was that he gave them the criteria for being a judge. And I think, by the way, that all the members in our church should know what the criteria is if they want to be a judge. You can be a judge. But the criteria for being a judge is this: he that is without sin. Let him cast the first stone. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? And I want you to know that when you tell me that the requirement for a rock thrower is to be sinless, then you just put me out of the rock throwing business. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I say I'm out of the rock throwing business. And by the way, you out of the rock throwing business too, if that is the criteria. I got to tell you something. I am not a rock throwing pastor, and I don't want a rock throwing church. Don't look at me like that. I'm serious. And so I want you to turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, put down your rocks. Drop them. I'm serious. Say, drop them.
Drop them. My God.
Why must we drop these rocks? Why is it that we must drop these stones? Well, I can't speak for you, but let me tell you why I have to drop mine. I have to drop mine because I too, like this woman, have come short. I too, like this woman, have stumbled and failed. I too, like this woman, have made mistakes. I too have come short of the glory of God. I got some of my religious folk that are looking at me now, and they're wondering what I mean when I say I too. That ain't your business between me and God. Yeah, what he talking about? Yeah, he get. Now you don't know. My secret is in heaven. Amen. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But I can tell you what you ought to be doing. You ought to be saying, raising your hand, saying, "I too." There ought to be somebody here ought to say, "I too have come short. I too have missed the mark. I too have come short of the God. I too, I need thee every hour." Am I right about it, somebody? Am I right about it, somebody? Am I right about it, somebody? Oh, God, I need you to bless me. I need your forgiveness. I need your mercy. I need it. Matter of fact, I'll take a double portion of it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me just say this to you again. Put down your rocks. Put them down. I saw some rocks when I came in here. Put them down. Yeah. Shouldn't have been a time ago. Getting ready to throw one at me. He coming back here. What he think he in there? I am the pastor. I is in charge. Says you gonna ask all that. Yeah. Put down your rocks. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Put down your rocks. Now, Let me get to this, back to the text. I'm trying to finish here. Y'all help me a little bit. But this woman was guilty of sin. She was guilty. This woman had been caught in adultery.
Yes, sir.
I mean, this is what they said. We actually saw it.
Yes.
Amen, life. I'd ask him, how long did you watch? Did you wait till they finished, or did you stop them in the middle? You see, my friends, these despicable people, while Jesus was on the Mount of Olives, I'm glad they didn't invite Jesus to their house. Because while Jesus was on the mountain praying before he came back into the temple, them jokers was peeping in pee holes. They were looking through people's windows like peeping Tom. Because that is the only way they could have caught the person dead to the right. This woman is guilty. And I want to just say this to you, and I don't mean this in any way to offend you, but the woman is as guilty as you and me. You say, well, I didn't commit adultery. Well, Jesus says if you thought about it, you're guilty. You say, well, I ain't never told a lie. You're lying already if you say that. Now, here's what the Bible says. He that keepeth the whole law, but yet offends in one point, is guilty of all. You understand that? That puts all of us in the same category. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Now, this woman is as guilty as you and I. And the law says that she is to be stoned. Are you hearing what I'm saying? The law says she to be stoned. And so now, here's the predicament they put Jesus in. That if he allows her to get away, then he has disobeyed the law of Moses. And they're going to stone him. That if indeed he does not shirk the law of Moses and say, okay, stone her, then he contradicts himself, because he said he came to love and to have compassion. Then he's a fraud. So then how does God, being both just and the justifier of a sinner, let a sinner get away free and not be ungodly? How can the just justify the unjust without being unjust himself? How does the holy, let the unholy get away scot-free without tainting himself and being unholy? The answer for her is the same answer for us. Jesus did not. He did not compromise the law. Jesus did not condone adultery. If anybody here thinks that Jesus is just giving away free tickets to adultery, you are wrong. You'd be waiting at the bus stop for a long time to get a ticket like that from Jesus.
This concludes part 3. Please resume this message at part 4.